place I stand and cast a wistful eye to Canaan's fair and happy land where my possessions lie. I am bound for the promised land, bound for the promised land. Oh, who will come and go with me? I am bound for the promised land.
Gospel music has now embraced about every kind of genre of music I can think of. Of course, Southern gospel, traditional gospel, inspirational gospel,
black gospel,
bluegrass gospel.
Bluegrass gospel.
Yes.
Contemporary, rock.
Rap.
I bet you got some of that in California, didn't you?
Yeah.
And it's neat to see all of these different kinds of genres of music come together in gospel music.
Yeah.
So basically what we're doing is adding something brand new to the mix. Western gospel.
Forever blessed, for I shall see my Father's face and in his bosom rest.
A neat thing that happened in Western music was when the Western movie became so popular, and Hollywood was making a lot of money from the Western movies, the producers decided they would add some really intricate arrangements, add orchestra, four-part harmony, and out of that, there was a big explosion of Western music. Back before it was country Western, it was Western.
Yeah, right.
And it wasn't until the 60s that they merged the two, because the fact that Western music was declining. But there was a handful of country artists like Johnny Cash, mm-hmm. and Patsy Cline.
Patsy Cline,
that
right.
helped yeah. prop up Western music for a while. And there's one song in particular, while we're talking about Patsy, that we recorded on this project that I had never heard before.
The song is That Wonderful Someone, and it was written by Patsy Cline's good friend. It's the only song she ever wrote, and Patsy was the only person to ever sing it and record it.
Beside you now.
Beside me.
Uncle Jack, who sang with Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys in the late 40s and up into the 50s, had a crush on Patsy Cline. He would sit up and listen to her records all night long.
Uncle Jack.
Uncle Jack.
Well, now tell me some of the songs that he sang with Bob Wills.
He sang San Antonio Rose and...
that's a big song.
Tater Pie, yeah. Lonnie Wubb.
Green-Eyed Woman.
Yeah. I remember that. Yeah. Only thing is, we couldn't listen to them.
Yeah.
You couldn't?
No, it was that was
worldly music.
Worldly music. Yeah. When Lyle and I were kids, we didn't get to listen to them unless we went to our grandma's.
Something interesting about Patsy Cline. She always wanted to record gospel songs, but they didn't always release everything that she recorded.
No, she had a couple in the can for years before they would let her release them, and she actually did it on her own and put them on one of her latest or last. Record albums that she produced.
One of her biggest gospel songs was Just a Closer Walk with Him.
Right.
I am weak, but thou art strong.
You know, one of the things I think is very interesting in us as a group is that our families and our parents were really into gospel and Western music. In fact, Lonnie and I's mom and dad met as young teenagers singing in a radio Western music contest and tied for first.
So they had to split the prize? What was the prize?
Man, I don't, it couldn't have been much.
Probably 50 cents.
My uncles used to do some of those contests like that, and they would win. Uncle Vester and Lee, they had a radio show back in the 40s on KFFA in Helena, Arkansas. And their claim to fame was they were doing their Sunday afternoon gospel program. And they just finished the first song when the engineer interrupted them and shut the program down and plugged in the President of the United States to give the Pearl Harbor address.
Oh, man.
Pearl Harbor
address. That's a trivia.
So, December 7th, 1941, I know exactly where my two uncles were.
Right. Right.
And they passed music down in our family. My dad has been a great songwriter all my life. I remember him writing these great gospel songs.
We sang three or four of his songs in the 70s.
The Goodmans recorded some of his songs. But there was one song in particular that never was recorded that he wrote in 1958, and we put it on this project.
Yeah.
I Love His Name.
Close by his side is where I long to be. I love his name.
One of my favorite cowboy writers from back in that era was Stuart Hamblin, and wrote great songs.
One of the first singing cowboys.
Yeah.
This Old House?
Yeah. That was probably his biggest hit, This Old House. But he wrote a lot of other ones.
This Old House was made popular by Rosemary Clooney.
No way.
It was a huge song, a secular song. It was gospel, but it made the secular charts.
Wow.
There is a great story. You might have heard it before, but Stuart Hamblin was a rough and rowdy guy.
Yeah.
He lived the typical Hollywood lifestyle, and if there's such a thing. But he was an alcoholic, and he'd tried everything to overcome it, and it was ruining his family life. It was ruining his career. He just had no control over his life anymore. And he found himself sitting in the stadium listening to a gospel message preached by Billy Graham.
Wow.
And he was one of the hundreds, perhaps thousands, that night that walked out onto the stadium field and gave his heart to Jesus.
I'd heard that.
Wow.
Well,
unreal.
After his conversion, he was always telling his friends in the movie business about what God had done for him, that he was able to lay the bottle down once and for all, and he got his home life back together, and everything was going well for him. His next door neighbor was John Wayne.
There you go.
And He was telling John about his conversion and how he didn't need to drink anymore. And somewhere in the conversation, he said the line, "John, it's no secret what God can do."
Oh, there you go.
Oh, man.
John Wayne said, "Stuart, you need to go home and write that. It sounds like it would make a good song."
Yeah.
And that's exactly what he did. He came out with, "It is no secret what God can do."
What a song.
The chimes of time ring out the news, another day is through. Someone slipped and fell. Was that someone you? You may have longed for an extra
Guys, one of my personal favorites of Stewart Hamlin's was Until Then.
One unique experience that I had with that song, it's the first song I ever sang in public. I sang it with Philip and another guy at church. I played stand-up bass, Philip played guitar.
How old were you?
I was 15.
15, and you were?
18.
18.
Yeah. That's a long time ago.
Great song.
We can't talk about Western music without bringing up the name of Hank Williams.
Hank Williams.
Great songwriter. Wrote lots of big hits.
He did.
Yes, he did.
One of the things that I remember is he wrote a lot of gospel songs.
He did. It's hard to believe that he died at 29.
Yeah.
Well, he lived a lot of life in those 29 years.
He did.
Years.
You can tell it in his songs.
You can. One of my favorite country songs that he wrote was I'm So Lonesome.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
His lyrics were simple but profound. They would just speak to many people's hearts.
And on the gospel side, we've recorded what I think was probably his most popular gospel song,
right.
I Saw the Light.
I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I would have led dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow.
Man whose popularity is rising again, and he's been gone for quite some time, that's Johnny Cash.
Yeah.
This newest generation is finding out about Johnny Cash music. Johnny Cash recorded one of my favorite songs of all time, When He Reached Down His Hand for Me, and I wanted to do that on this recording.
Yeah.
I don't know of anyone that can't associate with this song.
Yeah, particularly with Johnny Cash. I mean, like Stuart Hamlin, he'd had a life of problems, mm-hmm. with
some lows.
Low lows, mm-hmm. and had a great encounter with God, and he wasn't afraid to just tell people before he sang a song like When He Reached Down His Hand, what God really did for
yeah,
him.
Yeah, he meant it when he sang it.
Yeah, he did.
Once my soul was astray from the heavenly way, I was wretched and vile as could be. But the Savior above gave me
here's a point of trivia, guys. The first gospel song to top the country charts was a song written by Martha Carson. What do you think that was?
Well, her big song was Satisfied.
Satisfied.
That had to be in the early 50s.
I think it's 1951.
Martha Carson. Wow. But Satisfied was recorded by Johnny Ray, another big Western singer.
Yeah.
Don Gibson.
Yep. Connie Smith.
Connie Smith recorded it. Barbara Mandrell.
Dolly Parton.
Yeah, I played piano on the Dolly and Vestal Goodman version of that, yeah.
Great renditions.
Satisfied. There'll never be another one like that.
And we like singing it.
You may ask me if I'm happy, if I have sweet peace within, if I'm worried about tomorrow when I reach my journey's end. I'm satisfied with my Jesus. When he knocks, I let him in. He'll go with me through the valley, for I know he is my friend. Satisfied, satisfied. Satisfied.